1080p gaming, something that a Bangsawan like me has achieved almost 10 years ago with the Radeon HD 5970, but still remains a dream for most of you normal people. Not anymore! Almost 6 months after the green team gave us the RTX 3060, AMD has decided to give us their answer, which is the Radeon RX 6600 XT. Let's see if this graphics card that AMD says we should be able to get close to MSRP is able to bring 1080p gaming to the next level. Let's get cracking. Okay, jokes aside, there's actually a huge market for 1080p gaming, mainly for people who play esports titles and need very high FPS because they are competitive, so that they can no longer blame that their PC noob when they get pwned. I'm talking about you, Benny. AMD released the Radeon RX 6900 XT, 6800 XT and 6800 for 4K, then they dropped the RX 6700 XT designed for 1440p gaming, which we have previously reviewed, so feel free to check those videos out. Now AMD just launched the 6600 XT designed for 1080p gaming. In terms of specs, we're looking at a brand new Navi 23 chip, which is a quarter of the size of the Navi 21 on the RX 6800 and is quite a bit smaller than the Navi 23 on the 6700 XT. It also has 1 billion more transistors than the previous generation RX 5700 XT. In comparison to the next tier up, which is the 6700 XT, the 6600 XT has 20% less stream processors, compute units, and texture units. One-third the Infinity cache and also 4GB less VRAM that also has a smaller bandwidth. What is interesting is definitely the lower TDP at 160W, which should make this card a lot more efficient to run. But at a MSRP of $379 US, and we didn't actually get a Malaysian MSRP, is the RX 6600 XT going to be a good purchase in 2021? Before we move on to the benchmarks, let's check out this Powercolor Hellhound Radeon RX 6600 XT that AMD sent over for this review. Actually, a lot of reviewers and consumers have been complaining that manufacturers have been cramming the 6600 XT into the same thermal design and card design as higher end cards like the 6700 XT or 6800, given that the 6600 XT actually has a much lower TDP. In my humble opinion, the performance gain that you get with those bulkier 3 expansion slot design cards with the bigger heatsink and 3 fans is not actually worth the extra cost and size. This Powercolor card is very compact, looks pretty basic with an all-black plastic shroud with 2 fans with blue LED, no RGB here, paired with a black metal backplate with a brushed finish and a Hellhound logo at the top right. In terms of dimensions, it's 220mm long, 132mm wide and 45mm deep, which is basically a 2 expansion slot card. Like I said, pretty compact. In terms of thermal design, this card comes with 2 fans on top of an aluminum heatsink with 3 nickel-plated copper heat pipes and a copper base plate that is also nickel-plated. Here are the specifications to our test bench. Kicking off the benchmarks, firstly we have the synthetics, and the first one is 3D Mark x SPI. The 6600 XT beats the 5700 XT by up to 4%, but trails behind the 3060 Ti by quite a bit. The same can be seen in Unigine 1080p, but the older 5700 XT seemed to fare a little bit better in the 4K and 8K tests. Moving on to gaming benchmarks, Doom Eternal proves that the 6600 XT can definitely pump out more than 200fps for certain first-person shooter titles. It even hit 142fps average for 1440p, but it lost by quite a bit to the 3060 Ti and even by a tiny margin to the older 5700 XT. In Shadow of Tomb Raider, the 6600 XT beats the older 5700 XT by up to 7% in 1080p, but by just 1fps in 1440p. However, the 3060 Ti still comes ahead in both resolutions. One thing to note though is that the 6600 XT with ray tracing on is giving us a playable 58 frames per second in 1080p. But as usual, the green team still comes ahead quite a bit when it comes to ray tracing. Death Stranding sees our 6600 XT pull up slightly ahead of the 3060 Ti in 1080p, but lost by a couple of frames in 1440p. It still beat the older 5700 XT by about 4-5%. I'm quite surprised that Cyberpunk is actually playable in 1080p with the 6600 XT hitting 70fps, though I must say that this is one of those games that you should always get a card that is one tier above what you think you need. I'll be more comfortable gaming in 1080p with the 6700 XT. Finally, we have the real world benchmarks. Firstly, we have Puget, and we can see quite an improvement on the 6600 XT over the previous generation 5700 XT for Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve. This is quite assuring because this means that Radeon cards might be more viable for this kind of workloads in the future. Also, the performance difference with the 3060 Ti here is actually quite reasonable considering the price difference. In Blender, as usual, the green team is still ever so slightly better than the red team when it comes to 3D work. Lastly, we have the temps and acoustics, and the temps on this card is actually quite impressive, hitting only 55 Celsius for over 10 minutes under the Fermat stress test. In fact, it was doing all this while staying whisper quiet, only peaking at 48 decibels on rare occasions. It really pays to have bigger fans than you need. So, what's the verdict? Now, I know a lot of you guys must be upset because scalpers are probably jacking up prices as we speak, and also due to the fact that AMD Malaysia hasn't given us an official MSRP in Malaysia, so I'll just have to judge the card based on the American MSRP, which is $379, which would translate over to about 1,600 ringgit for the base models. Of course, you're gonna get higher end models that cost quite a bit more, so your mileage may vary. Here are the pros, mas, and cons of the RX 6600 XT. Next, we have the pros, mas, and cons to this Powercolor Hellhound graphics card. I give the Radeon RX 6600 XT a pretty good cheap buy, 7.5 out of 10, but I give the Powercolor Hellhound design an 8 out of 10 because it's very compact, has a pretty good thermal design, and is very quiet. From a sheer performance standpoint, the Radeon RX 6600 XT is actually one of the best entry-level cards that AMD has put out in quite a while, especially at such a low TDP. I can see this card, especially the smaller variants like this Hellhound model, being quite popular in entry-level 1080p gaming micro ATX or even mini ITX builds where the thermals and also size is of a concern. At the $379 starting price, the 6600 XT launched at about $50 more expensive than the RTX 3060, which we didn't have with us during this review, but according to other reliable sources, it has about 12 to 14% less performance compared to the 6600 XT. However, it is $20 cheaper than the RTX 3060 Ti, which outperforms it by about 11 to 12%. It even beats the previous flagship from AMD, which is the RX 5700 XT, by high single digits, at a much better power efficiency. But honestly, I wouldn't be too bothered about launch prices because it's quite unlikely that you'll be able to get this card or any other card for that matter close to the MSRP these days anyways. Based on this table from a subreddit, the RX 6600 XT has an Ethereum hash rate about 40% lower than the 3060 Ti but consumes less than half the power. But do take that with a grain of salt because the original post has been deleted and I got this from videocards.com. That and the fact that GPU supply has not caught up to demand just yet means that prices for this card is going to skyrocket. Now, if you need a card for 1080p gaming and prioritize FPS over fancy features like ray tracing and is able to get the 6600 XT close to retail price, then feel free to snatch it up because it is a very solid option. Also, full disclaimer, we didn't get to test out FSR that much because not a lot of games actually support it, especially AAA titles that would actually benefit from FSR with ray tracing turned on. So we'll just have to see what happens. And that's all, folks. I hope this review helped you out. If you want to buy this graphics card, don't forget to hit the link in our description so that we can get some links to you. If you thought this video is awesome, don't forget to like and share, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to see more content like this. And also don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Why? Because I want to follow you back. No, just kidding. I don't want to follow you. Finally, leave a comment down below lah, so that I can answer to you in the next comment section. Now we are going to move on to this comment section. For this week's comment session, I'm going to read the Acer Nitro 5 video because you know why? I have my crown with me today and because my hair is a bit... Firstly, we have RG Docs that says that the spin I did is giving him anxiety. That's right, bro. Don't try this at home unless you're Bangsawan. Kyron says that the 3060 is a very good deal. Exactly. Amir Jiggy says that he's the first, but actually he's not. He's the fifth one. Muhammad Ashru asked me that, oh, the pun really intended, man? Of course. Pun intended. Kenigma Life says, wow, so punny. So are you, bro. Hello Mamet says that I'm on fire. Where? I'm so bored. 2323 says, awesome review. You guys deserve more views, man. Exactly. So don't forget to share and like this video. To the 69 other commenters, I'm sorry I cannot reply to you because there are too many commenters. I am too popular. Try harder next time. Just kidding. Moving on to the wonderful world of Facebook. Mama Harif Hilmi says that he will auto-buy after watching this. See or not, Acer? Need a night, my RG, idiot. Jess Gill says, damn rhyme, lit, huh? And he's a supporter. That's why I have to feature him. Jeremy Tan keeps tagging his girlfriend Chong Yin and says, this is the one. Last time the laptop you saw, this is the one. Last time workstation you saw, this is the one. Wow, your girlfriend is your sugar mama, huh? Jet Damsha asks, Shane, apa yang kau pegang tu? Benda yang saya pegang tu? Tongkat ajaib. Azam Maslan tag Uchina out and say, can buy one lor? No, buy two, because two is better than one. Walter Wee is the new Bangsawan here because he bought the 4899 version and he's playing solitaire. Correct? I right Q. Everybody give him a slow clap. Nazru kata, this is a great review because ada orang reviewer tu buat iklan laptop gaming main PUBG tapi tak guna mouse. Kau dah tahu leh, mungkin laptop dia sangat hebat, dia boleh pakai dia punya telekinesis untuk gerakkan itu cursor. Kau tak tahu je sebab laptop dia ajaib. And that's all folks, leave more comment so I can reply to you, huh? And then I will see you in the next one. I need to remove my crown because heavy is the crown, correct? I don't know what I'm saying. I jumped. See you guys next time.